Welcome everybody to DerbyCon 6. This is the sixth year we've been doing this, so thank you all for coming. A round of applause for everybody that's here today. You know, when we get to Friday, you know, everybody here looks refreshed, and it's funny watching everybody's faces as they progress to Sunday. But we're actually extremely tired already because we've been up, I think I had a police call at 3 a.m. last night, so I took care of that. Good job on that one, folks. But also, we have a lot of folks here putting a lot of good time in. But what I want to do is, who's been here? Who's their first DerbyCon? Wow, look at that. That's amazing. Welcome. Welcome. Who here has been to two DerbyCons? Wow, that's great. Awesome. Who's been, Adrian, you don't count. Who's been to three DerbyCons? Wow, okay. Who's been to four? Wow. Who's been to five? All right. Who's been to all six? Look at that. Hey. I skipped one, so no. Thank you all for coming, and for the folks that keep coming continuously year after year. You know, this conference is really about trying to break down a lot of the barriers and social barriers that we have in this industry, and really kind of working together to really try to better the industry and get better with what we do. So I really appreciate everybody coming. Just a quick thanks to our sponsor, Milton Security. He's the top sponsor. Milton came all the way in an RV from California and drove the whole way with a empty Smirnoff Ice bottle on the side of their RV. And luckily enough, one of our guys, Justin, happened to be in a taxi and saw an RV with a Smirnoff Ice on the side of it. And was like, hey, is that you guys? You know, so it's amazing, you know, the adventures that everybody comes and does out here for making out the DerbyCon. So special thanks to Milton. Really recommend going to see those folks. They are a great group of people. Really happy. As well, coming from a platinum sponsor, Cobalt Strike. Those folks, Raph is awesome. He sponsors us year after year. I have nothing but good things to say about those that crew. And just in general to all of our sponsors, you know, please go through and say hi to them and just say, hey, thanks for helping sponsor DerbyCon, because without them, we couldn't get better year after year. And speaking of getting better, a lot of those things that we do is to make the conference better. We're 6 years in now, and it's been interesting the different progressions. When we first started with DerbyCon 1, we literally had no idea what we're doing. And today, we still literally have no idea what we're doing. But we become more efficient as we go along and add new things. Like, I won't spoil this. Am I allowed to spoil the screen? Well, there's a big screen behind us that we put up this year that Martin put up, and is doing with that. So we have a lot of great things we're adding. We get bigger bands. You know, we have the Method Man, Ren Man coming, and Panty Raid, and all those other different bands. So the conference just gets better every year, because of our sponsors and because of everybody here that makes this, this conference better. So go by and say hi to them, and all that good stuff. So normally we stuff bags. We do usually like 100 to 200 or a little bit more than that on Wednesday. But we ended up doing all of our bags on Wednesday. And I just asked on Twitter, hey, can anybody come and help us? It was Tuesday. Oh, I said Wednesday. My dates get blurred. Anyways, so I asked on Tuesday, can anybody come and help, you know, stuff bags? And people just came that were just coming in for training and everything else and started walking in and helping us stuff bags. And there's a lot of bags to stuff. So it took us, I think, about 5 or 6 hours. To go through all the bags. So any of you here that actually volunteered and came and helped, can you stand up? Got a few? Yep. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thank you. It's awesome. And I just want to say a special thanks to everybody that makes DerbyCon possible. The attendees, obviously, you coming here is the reason why we do this, and seeing everybody having a great time and having fun. That's the only thing we really get out of the conference, is being able to hang out with friends and meet new people. And that's the reason why we really do all this. There's a lot that goes into planning. Usually when we start DerbyCon, January 1st is kind of like our, you know, after Christmas and all that good stuff. We start our planning, and it's literally nonstop until we get to the point now to what we're doing. So, I'd like to go around the room and introduce everybody that, on the team that really helps make it happen. We have my wife, Erin Kennedy, the mastermind. She literally keeps us all organized and then yells at us when we're out of line. So she, not really. Just me. also, I want to say a special thanks to the security staff as well. And Paul Kolbitz is new. He's running the security team. But I want to give a round of applause for Nick Hitchcock and Banshee, who over the past 5 years have done a really awesome job on the security team, but aren't here today at this conference. So I want to give them a round of applause. So if you see Paul, red shirts, security, great folks, feel free to go to them. And I'll have Paul talk a little bit here in just a second about the security team. We've got Adrian Crenshaw, also known as Iron Geek. We got Kyle or Carl or Creepy, either one. He goes by all three. That's kind of his names. But Kyle has really been instrumental for a lot that we do and literally keeps us all online as well. Dave DeSimon, the beard, the epic beard of doom. And his lovely wife, Kim, as well. Who's also looking forward to Dave shaving his beard after the conference, right? Yeah. We got Martin Boss. We got Jason Ashton back here who runs a lot of the sound in the background. So thanks, Jason, for all the stuff you do. And where's Khalil at? Khalil, you're on here? He's probably still sleeping, most likely. But special thanks to Khalil for helping out as well. But, I mean, these folks have literally been in here since the day one, nonstop wiring, getting all the gear up. There was an issue with the stage where it was too big, so they were up to like 4 o'clock in the morning tearing the whole stage down and rebuilding it back up again. And I mean, these guys put in a lot of effort and run off of no sleep this entire time. But I also want to say a special thanks to anybody that is on the staff. Justin Elzey, who's been running the reg desk, and everybody else that's been at the reg desk, and all the folks that made the process. Was checking in easy? Yeah. Great. DevCon can learn from us, yeah. We have we like to tout the no line thing. So hopefully there was minimum lines during this entire time. Paul, do you want to talk a little bit about security?
Morning, everyone. Hope everyone is having a good con so far. I know it's just starting, but
trust me, at 3 o'clock I could hear everybody having a good time last night. So.
Yep. So I just want to say that you know we're here to help everyone have a fun, safe convention, and we hope that everyone else can help us out with that. We're all mostly grown, responsible adults. So let's just try and keep it that way. All right? Thank you.
Can you turn up just a little bit? The count I can hear in the back.
That's cool. So one thing to note, too, is, you know, stay safe. Treat everybody with respect. The Hyatt staff here is phenomenal. They really are one of the folks they're like literally an extension of the DerbyCon family. I mean, when you walked in, there was beer and you know, they're serving free booze in the front. And you know, they really try to take care of us. So treat them with the same amount of respect as everybody else. And be safe, you know, be cautious of people's personal space, things like that. You know, things that we know as an adult, but as we start to get a little inebriated, start to blur a little bit. So, you know, stay safe and do all that good stuff. Scott, you want to come up here with the CTF? So we do have events. We have a number of events planned for this this conference. We have the Hardware Hacking Village. We have the Car Hacking Village. We have the Crypto Challenge. We have the Capture the Flag. We have Lockpick Village. What else? Router hacking. So there's a lot of events. The events page on the website is the most accurate and up to date, as well as the schedule. So if you look in your handouts you have in your bags, the schedule is there, but it is subject to change. So use the website as your main method for your schedule and making sure that you get to your right talks and everything else. But Scott, you want to go over the Capture Flag?
So in our sixth year, obviously here, Dave goes, "Hey Scott, we need a CTF. You want to do it? Sure. What's that involve?
I don't know."
So we started at day one, and, you know, a couple of people playing, and now we're up to hundreds. So I'll keep it short for you. We are on the second floor in the conference theater, directly across from the escalators. We've got wireless. We've got wired. The information is in your handout book, as well as some posters around here. You must be connected to the wireless or the wired to play. And the instructions are there. It's self-registration. It models the penetration test. You're looking for flags in the environment. And then there's a scoreboard where you submit those flags to and you earn points. This year, we've got some great prizes. We have a sponsor, Cyber Reason. Let's give them a hand. For our prizes, we've got 10 prizes this year, one prize per team. We have a black badge. I don't know who would want that. We've got a DerbyCon ticket for next year, as well as a bunch of other cool gear. So check out your books, and if you have any questions, we'll be over there, and I hope to see you there. Thanks.
Good, perfect. Trent, where are you at, Trent? Trent's right here, the Iceman. People dread seeing Trent walking down the hallways. So A little history about this. You know, it all started off as kind of a fun game. It was at DerbyCon 1, I think, or something. DerbyCon 2. Trent comes over, and he's like, hey, man, you've been iced. I'm like, what's that? And I'm like, you have to drink the Smirnoff Ice if you get nailed. I'm like, oh, and I'm drinking, and it's terrible. It tastes horrible. And then we turn it into an official event at DerbyCon, so, because everybody hates Smirnoff Ice, and now we actually heat them up. We have cookers and all this other stuff. Cookers. FamilyCon. But one thing I want to say is, you know, obviously, at conferences and things like this, a lot of drinking. If you're not comfortable with the drinking aspect, please just, you know, say no, and that, you know, it won't ever be second guessed again. That's not a problem if you don't drink and all that good stuff. But you want to go through the rules and all that?
So basically how it works is if I was going to ice Dave, I'd have to meet and beat the armband that he currently has. So if I wanted to go and ice Dave, and I'll be dropping these off over at the Hacker for Charities. Are they here? Okay. I didn't know if they're set up yet, but they're $5. They go to charity. And are they here? Where you guys at? Okay. Sorry, I'm tired. I was up with Dave when the police were here. Yeah, long story. But so basically what it is if you want to ice someone, I see some blinking bands. So actually, there's 6 already out there, if you can find them in your chair. If you have them, look under your chairs real quick. If you have one of those bands, select someone that you want to ice and give it to them. And then I'll, Corey, can you help me find those people that have the blinking? So, you guys got the bands? Raise your hand if you got a band. Okay. If you don't want to take the ice, give it to someone and we'll ice them. If you want it, we'll bring it over. There's a couple over here. And I have a special one because this guy actually threw his. So there you go. And he doesn't get, so they're immunity banned. So like, if you want to trump someone, go over to Hacker's Charity. It's a fun game. And, those that are getting iced right now, come find me and I'll give you another ice to introduce yourself to somebody else. Cause it's a fun game to introduce people because they'll never forget you if you ice someone.
Literally, it's an icebreaker. Funny story about this. Last year with this, Trent came up with this idea, he had a wireless speaker set, and it was Sunday, and everybody was so tired and hungover, and, you know, someone's walking, you'd hear like a weird crackling sound over on the left-hand side when you're walking, and you look over, and it was a message saying, if you're looking at this, you've been iced, and it's Trent there, you know, smiling with a Smirnoff Ice Sunday morning. You know, it's one of the worst things ever. And you learn when you're doing this, when you're heating up Smirnoff Ice, that you don't want to get too hot with it, because they explode everywhere in your room. And they're very sensitive. So I dropped one earlier as we were getting ready for the conference, and it sprayed all over Trent and Zero and a lot of the other guys. So be careful. It's a dangerous game. Dangerous game. Ben and Charles, you want to come up here? Black Badge? From Level 1? So every year we've been handing out black badges for a number of different events. We have an auction and closing ceremonies to buy black badges. All the proceeds go to charity. And we also have a number of events like Capture Flag, as well as others, where we do black badges. But, you know, what we started looking at is how can we improve every year, and, you know, get black badges to be, you know, cooler and better, year after year and go from there. And, the guys over at Level 1, stood up and was like, hey, we'll do your black badges for you. So we wanted to show you that and give you a little bit of a taste of last year's black badge and what the new, the new ones will be released on Sunday. So I just wanted to show these here.
Sure. All right, I haven't had any sleep either. So we got approached to do these earlier in the year, and so we designed a 2016 badge, which is pretty epic, but we can't tell you about it yet. You have to wait till Sunday. And then kind of last minute they said, could you also do a 2015 badge for us? And we said, sure. So we threw this together. We took the artwork from the graphic designer, and Charles laid out a board, and we hashed out how we wanted the electronics to work and what sort of animation to put on, and we spend all night making them. So, I'm exhausted. I don't know what else you want to say.
Thank you so much. No. Thank you so much. I appreciate your work.
Thanks.
So if you're one of the folks that got it from last year, and you're getting your 2015 badge, go to the shirt desk after our opening ceremonies, and you can go pick those up or throughout the time. Shirt sales start at noon as well, just a heads up on that, okay? So why we do it, and a little bit of the history of DerbyCon if you're new here. You know, a number of years ago, you know, Adrian contacted a number of us, and it's funny because, you know, Martin, Adrian, and myself, we've known each other for a number of years, and Martin wanted to do a CTF at the Louisville ISSA a number of years ago, and, you know, we were on IRC all the time and everything, and Adrian was actually running the CTF. And so Martin's like, hey, can you be on my CTF team? I want to break in and, you know, win this because, you know, us together, you know, we'll tear into everything. And so I'm nervous about CTFs because, like, you know, I don't like going in and going against people and stuff like that. So I'm like, all right, well, we'll go and do it. So we happen to be hacking into this CTF challenge for the Louisville ISSA, and Adrian was running the CTF, and I see that there's this fully patched Windows Vista box. And at the time, it was in the same subnet. You forgot to unplug it. So I happened to be working on this Vista Zero Day at the time, and had it working like 2 weeks before, and hadn't been published or anything like that. And so I see this perfectly patched Windows Vista machine on there. I'm like, oh, well, it's in the subnet range of the CTF. It must be legit. So I broke into it, and I'm like, man, Adrian really makes this CTF stuff look real, because like, there's like Adrian videos and Adrian pictures, and I was actually really scared to look at the Adrian pictures folder. I didn't want to go there. But then I saw there's like a little folder there. It's like, hey, you know, DerbyCon the Louisville ISSA CTF videos, and it was videos to show you how to do each of the you know, CTF flags. So I start downloading. I'm like, hey, this is really cool. I figure, you know, hey, you get a zero day, you get the answers to all the things. And I'm starting to think, like, this is pretty real. I mean, like, you know, I mean, there's a lot. There's, like, email on here. I'm like, I don't think you spent that much time. So I went up to Adrian. I'm like, hey, do you have a Windows Vista box that's fully patched? And he's like, oh, no. So after that, the three of us became really good friends. And Adrian, you know, I'd been to Louisville a couple of times, but Adrian wanted to throw a Metasploit class for free, and I think our initial goal is we wanted like 25 people or something like that. Yeah, so it was a charity event, and we wanted to get 25 people. We ended up getting like 150 or something like that. So we get 150, and so after we do this whole day of training classes, all of us and another individual, Alex Ka, who was awesome as well, who was part of this as well, we all went in and were like, hey, we should start a conference here in Louisville. It'd be awesome. And so we decided to start DerbyCon, because we liked the whole feel of the tight-knit community. And it's something that I grew up with, you know, in the early DEF CON days around DEF CON 9, at the Lexus Park. And so, you know, we really wanted to try to recreate that same feel. There we go. There we go. Battery checks. So that's the reason why we started DerbyCon, is to bring that community feel, remove the barriers. Feel free to go up to anybody. There's no clicks or anything around here. That's really what we like to do. Just a little bit on the DerbyCon financials. You know, people wonder why we do this conference, and none of it is monetary at all. Every year that we get the money coming into the conference, we have the money going out of the conference, which means that we spend it all on the conference itself. To really try and make it the best it can, either for the year there or the year after. So we don't make any money off the conference. Our goal isn't to drive any money from the conference at all. It's really to try to make it an awesome place and an awesome experience. And we literally just do this for the fun, you know, of making it and doing all that. So, you know, a lot of things to come. You know, if you look at what we have this year, Martin was able to somehow to pull off Method Man and Red Man. I don't know how that's possible. Next year, I'm not gonna say anything. Every year I'm like, Martin, can we get this person? He's like, oh my gosh. He's like, we got to figure out how to do this. So next year we might have an even bigger person. We're going to try really hard to get this person. If it happens, I'm going to be like, literally, I've wanted this since DerbyCon 1. If this person comes, this band or group or whatever, you know, Justin Timberlake is my dream here, but,
I quit.
You quit? We just wanted to play the one song, Can't Stop the Feeling, over and over again for the whole time. No, but again, you know, Friday night we have the really big party. Saturday we also have a very big party. So we're really excited. Dual chorus playing. We have a number of great openers. YT Cracker, right? A number of others. Is it what? Yeah. And then a number of other folks playing. So we have some really great things happening because of the conference growing. So that's one of the big things that we do with the financials, is getting bigger badges. You know, we are able to do coffee now for the mornings for the training. And, you know, just to try to make the conference better and better. CTF sponsors. I mean, a lot of good stuff. Streaming, you could find, after lunch, we're going to have all of the channels in your rooms. So you can see tracks 1 through 5, in the rooms themselves. So, channel 82 to, through 85. So you can see in your rooms, if you're just, you know, want to relax and kick back and get away from the crowd or whatever, you can go into those and see that. Additionally, it's streaming live. And then all the videos are posted very quickly thanks to Iron Geek's Ninja Skills on video. So, phenomenal. This guy goes from conference to conference and literally has the largest collection of InfoSec history and videos I think that is ever out there. So how many gigs do you think you have?
I have no clue.
Well, it's not gigs at this point. It's
a lot of stuff.
So, you know, you can definitely stream it, but the videos will be available. So if you miss a talk and all of those, we'll miss those. Speaking of that, obviously we're a little bit tight here, right? And what happens in conferences is that you get talks that are very popular and a lot of folks want to go to. And due to the space restrictions, sometimes that might not be possible. So we appreciate, you know, and respect that you want to get to a talk, and sometimes it may not happen. We try to keep the attendance rate down enough so that you can get to those talks. And I try to balance the talks a lot to make sure that there's a good distribution. So hopefully everybody gets to make the talks that you want to, and apologize for the space restrictions. And that leads me into some big news. So the Hyatt has been awesome for us year after year. And last year, I had put out to the DerbyCon attendees about possibly splitting the conference between the Hyatt and the Marriott so that we could have some tracks over there and some tracks over here to kind of split them up so you can do it. We started looking at that, of possibly doing that this year, and we looked at it, and it wasn't feasible because you had to walk a lot and you had to go back and forth. So it wasn't going to work out well, so we decided against that. But we are going to be moving to the Marriott, not next year, but the year after. So, you know, the Hyatt has been fantastic for us. We love them. I was actually crying on the phone when I told them that we're moving over to the Marriott because, you know, we're not planning on growing the conference. We're going to maybe like a few hundred people max, but there's a lot more space over there for us to be able to go. There's 2 big ballrooms, so the space restrictions allow us to not be so tight in the chairs and give you some breathing room and all that other stuff. So it made sense for us as a conference to move over there, but we definitely want to sell out the Hyatt again, you know, every year and get, you know, some events over here and stuff like that to keep the folks involved in that. So, you know, I just want to give the Hyatt a round of applause for being awesome for us. I mean, they're just amazing. So again, not next year, okay? Next year we're still here. So don't start booking at Marriott right now and be like, oh, DerbyCon's next year, right? Next year is going to be here still, and we'll have a great going away party and everything for the folks that do so awesome here. But the year after, we'll be moving to the Marriott. So just a heads up on that, okay? So this is your first DerbyCon. I wanted to play closing ceremonies from last year, video from closing ceremonies last year, to give you a kind of a feel of what it is and what you're in for, because it's a lot of fun and a lot of craziness. So I'd like to play a video from last year. Too much music, sorry.
Can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you. Song is meant to keep you doing what you're supposed to. Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pancakes, pretend like it's the weekend now. We could pretend it all the time. Can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But just maybe, like a ukulele, mama made a baby. Really don't mind the practice, cause you're my little lady. Lady, lady, love me, cause I love to lay you lazy. We could close the curtains, pretend like there's no world outside. Then we could pretend it all the time, Lord. And can't you see that it's just raining? outside. Ain't no need, ain't no need. Can't you see, can't you see? Rain all day and I don't mind. But the telephone's singing, ringing, it's too early, don't pick it up. We don't need to, we got everything we need right here, and everything we need is enough. Just so easy when the whole world fits inside of your arms. Do we really need to pay attention to the alarm? Wake up slow, wake up slow. But baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you this. Song is meant to keep you doing what you're supposed to. Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pancakes, pretend like it's the weekend now. We could pretend it all the time. And can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. Ain't no need, ain't no need. Rain all day and I really, really, really don't mind. Can't you see, can't you see?
That was a good year. But I have a feeling this year's going to be better. So make it a great conference. Have a lot of fun. And we look forward to being with you guys and gals and kids and friends throughout this whole conference. So have fun. We're going to kick off here with Jeff and Lee here in just a few minutes. Got about 15 minutes before our opening keynote. And we'll go from there. So welcome to DerbyCon. Have a great time.